government shut down, so too are many of the roads that weave through the Gettysburg battlefield.
Not only are the barricades blocking cars, but also businesses in a town that depends on tourism. For businesses, the shutdown has created a feast or famine scenario. News 8's Matt Barcaro explains.
This is Levi and Mark Remington.
At Hickory Hollow Farm near Gettysburg, it's not just the horses feeling penned in lately.
He got two cans, he gets one can.
Their owner, Pam Grimes, hasn't had much to do either. Not since the government shutdown shut down the battlefield trails her horses have taken tourists for 30 years.
It's hard. Like your whole world's been flopped over. And
she says normally at this point in October, she would have led about 50 tours. But with the battlefield closed, she has only led four. She's losing money, and the horses still have to eat.
When it's your only income, it's like, wow, big slap in the face. So we improvise.
She improvised by running those four tours around the farm her family owns. It's not much, but a nice consolation for Sandy Taylor from Virginia, who had a horseback battlefield tour on her bucket list.
But so you kept thinking, oh, it's going to pass, you know, it's going to go away, and the federal government's going to come back up, but didn't happen. So, you know, you make the best of a bad situation.
Sandy was not able to tour the battlefield, but still had plenty to do.
Turns out a lot of people are doing what Sandy did, coming downtown to places not run by the National Park Service and paying a visit.
One of those places is the Shriver House Museum, a family-run attraction that tells the story of a Gettysburg family that lived through the battle.
It's absolutely been amazing. We've had more walk-in visitors than we've ever had in all these years.
The tourists who did not cancel their plans are filling these smaller sites while the battlefields are barren.
Some people have said that they were, not that they're happy, none of us are happy that the government has shut down, but that they're happy they got to come in and see this story, because otherwise they would never have come here.
Two businesses, two results from a government shutdown having a hand in what is open and what's closed. In Gettysburg, Matt Barcaro, News 8.